in blue-green algae, that is Nostoc, Anabina, Oscillatoria. So these are the three type studies are completed yesterday onwards. So today we are going to discuss the another topic related to virus, my dear friends. Virus and bacterial disease are four diseases we will going to discuss today and tomorrow. And today we are going to discuss about the rice tungro disease, that is rice tungro virus. Okay, shall we continue?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what are the significance related to this tungro means, what is the meaning of this tungro? Tungro means degenerated growth or stunted growth, which is nothing but a dwarf growth. So this tungro is called as cancer because of several damages observed on the plant. This tungro disease affected in virus. Tungro disease affected in virus in paddy field or rice field. Tungro was first diagnosed in 1963. The disease is reported from Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, India, and Pakistan. So most of the Asian countries are affected this tungro disease. Anybody can explain why these Asian countries is able to disperse this disease, tungro disease, the tungro virus in paddy field? Why? Anybody can discuss? Anybody can tell? Are you know about this information? No. Okay. The Asian countries mainly the tropical and subtropical countries are there. So that's why these disease spread. The temperature is very suitable for the growing of this disease. The symptoms are appeared on the different parts of the plant is very suitable environment in our Asian countries. So that's why this disease reported and spread over the Asian countries. Okay, then rice tungro virus disease is one of the most damaging and destructive of rice in South and Southeast Asia, also southern parts of China. So China is also in our Asian continent, you know. According to Krishnaveni et al. 2011, his research report, and Indonesia is perpetually affected by the disease. The area affected varying from 60,000 25,000 hectares annually. Per annum, 16,000 to 25,000 of the hectares are affected this disease. Then, the annual loss due to tungro disease is estimated at American dollars, US dollars, that is 1.5 billion. Around the globe or globally. How many billion, Sama? 1.5 billion US dollars. And distribution in India, this rice tungro distribution in India in different states, that is West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Assam, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala. In our state, in our both the Telugu states along with the Andhra Pradesh state, the distribution of rice tungro has become sporadic in most of the rice growing tracts of Andhra Pradesh. In Telangana, especially some of the districts related to Medak and Nalgonda districts were reported. And till now, the disease has been reported from East Godavari and Chittoor and Prakasham districts of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so these are the distribution related in our Telugu states. Please mute yourself, Amma. Please. Then distribution in world, the entire world, the distribution of this disease of different large distribution. Very nice. The sound is very disturbing, Amma. Please. Thank you. Okay, can I start? Continue. Sir, distribution in world. Distribution in world, Africa, Asia, Australia, Europe, South America, North America. So these are the continents.
Screen is not visible, sir.
Okay.
Sir, what happened, sir?
So, from your side, noise is very disturbing, madam. Okay, shall I continue? This slide is visible.
Yes, sir.
So
now it's okay, sir.
Yeah, it's okay, madam. It's okay. The distribution in the world, this rice grain was distributed along with Asia, the Africa, Asia, Australia, Europe, South America, North America. So what we confirmed, ma'am? What we confirmed is the not only the rice to grow is reported in Asia, but it distributed entire the world, all continents, you know, all continents. Is it right or not? Africa, Asia, Australia, Europe, South America, North America. So these are the all continents are suitable for this growing of this distribution of this rice to grow business. And what are the symptoms we observed on the paddy field? In the paddy field, on the surface of the different parts of the plants, the symptoms depends upon the host cultivar. In the cultivar TN1, the seedling shows a stunting with mottling and yellowing of leaves. This cultivar TN1, the seedlings, whenever the seedlings they are show stunting. Stunting means the dwarf, the growth is stopped. The growth is going to stop. And the mottling, the number of spots, different patches are absorbed on the parts where are the stem and the leaves also. And colors of the leaves is going to turn into yellow. My dear friends, here reduced tillers, yellowing and orange yellow coloration of leaves is common symptoms. So the main symptoms are absorbed or occurred on the surface of the leaves. The whenever the green leaves are going to yellowing and different colors or different patches or spots we are absorbed on the leaves. And my dear friends, whenever this disease attacked on this field, disease we are absorbed on the paddy field, the flower is going to delay. The flower is delaying. Flower is dealing. The most panical sterile are partially filled grains. So the what we can say that whenever disease is attacked on in the paddy field, the grain is going to sterile form or partially filled. Simply put, thali poyindi mettabadi unnai antaru chudandi andulo grain undadu. So only the only sterile grains we are absorbed. So these symptoms we are absorbed, the how yellowing from the tip to downwards here. This is tip to downwards here. These are the yellowing color. The leaf is going to turn into yellow color. I am stunted with reduced tillering. So whenever the disease attacked on this in the paddy field of this crop, the plants of this paddy or rice plant is not able to grow. The growth is stunted or reduced. So the dwarf plants we are observed in the field of the entire field of the paddy. So the growth is stunted and the leaves, the coloration of the leaves also turned into green into yellow. yellowish color. So these are the symptoms we are observed in the rice tungro disease. Are you visible? This slide is visible, Amma? The stunted growth. The stunted growth of this rice and along with this, the coloration of the leaves also varies from the normal leaves. So this yellowing, whenever the coloration of the leaves, the color, yellow color is going to turn into orange yellow color. So in previous slide, what we observed, only yellow color we are observed. In this slide, the leaves are going to the complete orange color. So these are the maturity level of the disease level. And at the same time, this slide shows how the plants is going to affect this virus, and this growth is stopped. That is the stunted growth or dwarf growth we are observed in these plants. And what are the pathogens caused by these tungro disease? The disease caused by virus. The virus related to tungro bacilliform virus. Tungro bacilliform virus. And the second pathogen is tungro spherical virus. Tungro spherical virus. So these are the two virus or the pathogens caused by this caused of this tungro disease. Caused of this tungro disease. Okay. This slide is visible. So why this virus we can call the bacilliform virus? So virus is So here, this tungro bacilliform virus is a rod shaped. The virus is a rod shaped virus. You know, bacilli means rod shape. Bacillus means rod shaped. You know. Then whereas the spherical shape means the virus is in is a globular shape, as a round shape, is a spherical shape. That's why the pathogen we can call as tungro bacilliform virus. Tungro spherical form virus, spherical virus. Spherical means a globular structure, you know. So bacillary form means a rod shaped structure. So these are the two pathogens caused of this tungro disease. So these pathogens looks like here. So these are the bacilliform virus. These are the spherical virus, the spherical virus, bacillus and spherical. See here, this structure in this under the microscope, this 100 nanometer length we are observed. These are the bacilliform virus, whereas these are the spherical form virus, bacilliform and spherical virus. Is it right? So the pathogen, what are the characteristic features are related to this bacilliform virus and spherical virus? What is the abbreviation of this RTBV, my dear friends? RTBV.
Very good.
Rice tungro bacilliform virus. Then RTSV. See here. RTSV means Rice tungro spherical virus. RTSV. So RTBV is the contain, the virus contain the double stranded DNA, whereas RTSV spherical virus is contain the single stranded RNA. So the genetical material is varies from these two pathogens. One is double stranded DNA and the second one is single stranded DNA, my dear friends. At the same time, the RTBV virus is a cause of mild stunting and yellowing of leaves. The stunting and yellowing leaves are caused by this RTBV. Whereas the RTSV, only the mild stunting. There is no yellowing. There is no coloration of the leaves. There are no symptoms we are observed on the leaves of the surface in the paddy field, my dear friends. Only the whenever the yellow coloration or brown coloration, orange coloration of the leaves, just because of this RTBV virus. Is it right or not? Rice tungro bacilliform virus, the bacilliform virus is caused by the stunting and yellowing of the leaves. Is it right? And my dear friends, it belongs to, RTBV belongs to then Budna virus, the group, the particles of 10 to 100 to 400 nanometer long and the diameter, the 30 to 35 nanometer in diameter of this RTBV. Whereas the RTSV, isometric with the diameter 32-33 nanometer length. The, what is the systematic classification of these two groups or these two viruses? The these two groups of the viruses is varies from one from another. Why? Because the genetic material is different, and even though the entire classification is different from these two pathogens. The first pathogen, that is RTBV, that is the group belongs to 7, that is containing double-stranded DNA genetic material, and the family of this RTBV virus, that is the Calimoviridae family, the genus Tungrovirus, the species is Rice Tungro-Bacilliform virus, as reported in 1975 by Salto. Okay, then the second pathogen, that is RTSV, that is spherical virus. The group of this spherical virus is group 4. The genetic material in this RTSV, single-stranded RNA. The family belongs to this RTSV, Sequiviridae. The genus are Vicavirus. The species Rice Tungro spherical virus. So here Tungro virus is there and Vicavirus is there. They're both are affected in this paddy field, my dear friends. So both are caused by stunted growth, but whereas this Rice Tungro bacilliform virus is able to produce the symptoms on the surface of the leaves, the yellow coloration and orange coloration. But Rice Tungro spherical virus is not able to show the symptoms absorbed on the surface of the leaves. And what are the vectors related to the spread over this disease among the crop field? The green leafhopper is the main source of the transmission of this virus from affected or diseased plant to the infected plant to other healthy plants are among the crop field. Here, the Tungro virus by 6 leafhoppers, not only a single leafhopper, the 6 leafhopper species which are in the genus of related to Nepatotex species, my dear friends. Nepatotex are the leafhoppers or grasshoppers. The Nepatotex are the leafhoppers. These are the main cause of the transmission of this viruses, my dear friend. The Nepatotex virus lays its eggs in a batches of up to 44 in the tissue of leaf sheath of rice tillers. So the Nepatotex is the imago stage, the insect which is laying eggs up to 44. In one batch. Batch means the group of eggs, we can call it as batches. Batches means the group of eggs, you know. The group of eggs of the insects, we can call it as batches. So how many batches? 44 batches, my dear friends, not only a single egg. So 40, the group of batches are 44 in the tissue of the leaf sheath of the rice tillers. And after hatching means incubation. After hatching, there are 5 nymphal stages before adult emergence. So at the optimal temperature for this development of this leafhopper or grasshopper, 30 to 35 degrees Celsius is the adaptive environment for the development of this the complete growth of this leafhopper or grasshoppers. The leafhoppers species are grasshopper green leafhopper is Nepatotex virescens and Nepatotex nigropictus and Nepatotex malayans, Nepatotex parvus, Nepatotex apicalis. Those these are the species related to the leafhoppers of the transmission of these viruses. And the host plant is mainly the species of Oryza species are the main host, but at least 63 species of grasses can be infected. So not only a primary host or the main host, even though the secondary host or accessory host or additional host related to grass species, my dear friends. The natural occurrence on grasses in and around rice fields is reported. However, all except Oryza species are poor host of the vectors. The main host or the primary host of this Tungro virus is mainly Oryza sativa or Oryza species. Then horticultural crops like black pepper, toro and cocoa and yam. These are the crops also act as a host for these diseases. And this is cycle of the spherical virus and bacilliform virus along with the transmission by these grasshoppers, leaf hoppers by RSTV, rice tungro spherical virus that is dispersed or spread over the entire crop field. Then virus vector interactions. When young nymphs and adult green leaf hopper feed on dispersed or diseased plants, virus particles get attached to mouth parts, that is stylets. As these insects fly and feed on other plants, the virus particles from the stylets get introduced to healthy plants. Whenever the leaf hoppers attacked on the surface of the leaves, these infected the healthy plants. The insects pick up virus particles within 7 minutes of feeding and can transmit these particles to other healthy plants. Generally, Tungro virus disease symptoms appear. Then transmission mainly by leaf hopper vector, that is the nematodes virescens, males and females and nymphs of the insect can transmit the disease. So wherever not only the male, even though female nematodes virescens also caused by transmission of this disease, and the both of the particles are transmitted semi persistently in the vector, the particles are non-circulative and non-propagative. Plants infected with RTSV alone may be symptomless or exhibit only mild stunting. There are no symptoms arises on the surface of the leaves. Only the stunted growth observed with naked eye in RTSV with RTSV virus. Then RTBV enhances the symptoms caused by RTSV. The RTSV can be acquired from the infected plant independently of RTBV, but acquisition of RTBV is dependent on RTSV. Here, what we observed, my dear friends, not only RTBV affected on the healthy plants, along with RTSV, RTBV very, very rapidly spread over the healthy plants of the crop field. So both are simultaneously attacked on the healthy plants of the paddy field. Is it right or not, my dear friends? So RTSV which acts as helper virus for RTBV. Is it right or not? Even single RTBV not only able to infect the healthy plants, but with the help of RTSV, RTBV spread over the healthy plants in the crop field of paddy. Is it right or not? So both the virus thrive in rice and several weed host, which serves as source of inoculum for the next. Then what is the epidemiology? What is the epidemiology? The mode of spread by the vector borne, that is nematodes virescens. Then primary source of for Tungro includes stubbles of previous crops, infested plants, that is infected plants in nearby rice field. So these are the main source for the spread over the viruses. Then what are the favorable conditions for spread over the viruses among the crop field? Then presence of the virus source, that is the number one. Then presence of the vectors, that is the leaf hoppers, nematodes, and age and susceptibility of host plants. Age and susceptibility of the host plants. All growth stages of the rice plants, specifically the vegetative stage. Then ecosystem. Ecosystem is also very important, my dear friends. Whenever the irrigated and rain-fed lowland ecosystem is suitable for the favorable conditions for the spread over the crop field. Then what are the diagnostic methods we are used for this disease or this virus? There are five different diagnostic techniques for tumor growth. Number one, symptomatology, then transmission test, iodine or starch test, and serological test, electron microscopy. By using these methods, we are diagnosing whether the crop field is affected by these two genes or not. Is it right or not? Okay. Then culture methods. So management of rice tumor grow virus. So culture methods also very, very important, my dear friends. Then planting of resistant of the varieties against tumor grow virus disease is the most economical means of managing the disease. My dear friends, any disease, before going to sowing of the seeds or crop field, the resistant varieties is most important. So resistant varieties are most important of the selection by the farmer. So this is most important. Then second one, the resistant varieties like IR36, IR50, ADT37, Ponmani, CO45, CO48, Sureka, and Vikrama, Vikramarya, Bharani, and White Pony. So these are the varieties related to our paddy field. Are you heard about these varieties related to our paddy field, ma? Our rice crop, paddy varieties, IR22.
No, sir.
The different varieties are present in the market and the fertilizer shops. Okay. So these are the some varieties of these rice tumor grow resistant varieties. Number one, ADT37, this slide shows this image, ADT37, and this image varieties of the resistant of our tumor grow virus, CB01105 and CO48. So these are the two varieties of resistant varieties. And culture methods. Whenever we are using this culture, the neem seed cake applied at 5 kg for 0.03 to hectare of nursery, followed by foliar spray of 5% neem kernel extract in the main field reduced vectors population and incidence of tumor growth. And whenever the flowing and harrowing the field to destroy stubbles right after harvest in order to eradicate other tumor growth host are also advisable. Though this is the second method. And third method is destruction of weed host on burns. So weed host also responsible for the spread over the virus among the healthy crop field, because not only these rice tumor grow not only affect the only paddy host, even though the other grass also, other weeds also. So the destruction of the weeds also very, very important in, my dear friends, in the crop field. So this is the neem cake whenever the flowing to incorporate the stubbles. Okay. And mechanical methods. So we are using mechanical method also. In these mechanical methods, we are using light traps. So these light traps mainly absorb of the leafhoppers or the grasshoppers. So these leafhoppers or grasshoppers are traps by this artificial light traps, you know. So in these traps, the leafhoppers or the vectors is going to bind are picked in this artificial light traps, and this should be practiced every day in the crop field. And the second method is chemical method. By using of the different chemicals, the spraying over the crop field, okay, then mixed urea mixed with manco gem. Urea, are you heard about the term urea? It is an inorganic fertilizer, you know, in fertilizer shop. Urea,
yes,
sir. So urea, so 2% of the urea we are mixing with manco gem. Manco gem is a one of the fungicide or pesticide. Both these are mixed with at 2.5 gram per liter and spread on the crop field. And instead of urea, foliar fertilizer like multi potassium nitrate, multi K means potassium nitrate, can be sprayed at 1%, which impart resistance also because of high potassium content. And along with this, spray insecticides twice, 15 and 30 days. So each and every 15 days or 30 days after 1 month, the spraying insecticides. Okay, and after transplanting. So these are the chemical methods how we are spraying 2% of the urea with manco gel. So this is the manco gel, and how to use the apply of the carbofuran capsules. Are you heard about the term carbofuran capsules, my dear friends? Carbofuran capsules are Iran capsules are the very very used for the for the applying of chemical methods for the control of this disease, my dear friends. And at the same time, this are you visible? This multi K is potassium nitrate. You know, potassium nitrate. So multi K also is able to the control of this disease, my dear friends. And these are the 4-8 capsules. 4-8. And the third method is biological method. So first one is physical method. The second one is chemical method. And third one is biological control or biological method. In this method, we are using two fungi, that is Bavaria bassiana. This is the one type of the fungi. And the second one is Phaseolomyces, amyonerosus. Phaseolomyces, amyonerosus. These are the two fungi is able to control the these parasites, and these fungi are reported as parasites of rice grain leaf hopper, not viruses. These are the parasites of rice grain leaf hopper, that is nepatotrix virescens. So whenever these fungi attack and nepatotrix virescens, the leaf hoppers or grasshoppers is going to die. And whenever we are using the spray of Canadian, a suspension of the fungi on rice plants, kills the vectors. Vectors means all insects, especially nepatotrix leaf hoppers. Okay, these are the biological control. And the second type of disease, the second disease we are going to discuss here. Amma, are you have any doubt? Is there any doubt, Amma, related to tungro virus, rice tungro disease? Is there any doubt, rice tungro virus? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
We will move for next disease, that is tobacco mosaic disease. We already discussed about tobacco mosaic virus, you know, TMV. TMV is a first identified, the first virus, that is tobacco mosaic virus, TMV, consists genetic material, that is single stranded RNA. Is it right or not? So tobacco mosaic virus is identified all over the disease, all over the world, not only in Asia. So all continents of the world, my dear friends, even in our country, all states are facing this tobacco mosaic virus disease in tobacco crop. And 150 species affected tobacco, tomato, potato, brinjal. Are you any related this plant, someone? Tobacco, tomato, potato, brinjal. Is there any similarities of these plants, my dear friends? Is there any similarities? So these all plants are related to Solanaceae family members, my dear friends. Tobacco, tomato, potato, brinjal, datura. Okay, you know. So these are all plants related to Solanaceae. Solanaceae members are affected by this tobacco mosaic virus, my dear friends. Not only in tobacco plant, whereas all the plants related to Solanaceae members also. Is it right or not? But remain, this tobacco tomato is most destructive by this tobacco mosaic virus. And my dear friends, whenever this tobacco mosaic virus is affect on the crop field, the quality is also reduced. Even the quantity is also reduced, my dear friends. Are you accept or not? And quality, how much of quality loss? The quality till 33% of the quality loss due to this cause of this tobacco mosaic virus on these healthy crop plants. And even though the quantity also lost more than 50%, my dear friends. So half of the crop yield is also lost for each and every crop of the tobacco. Not only tobacco, potato, tomato also, my dear friends, all Solanaceae members. And these symptoms are first appeared on new leaves, that is younger leaves. Yeah, so we are first observed on the younger leaves, my dear friends. The leaves are mottling. So leaves are mottling. Mottling means the group of the spots or patches we are observed on the surface of the leaves, my dear friends. So the leaves are not only a single colors, my dear friends. They are the green and yellowing leaves, the orange color, the brown color, and different types of the leaves. Different colors of the leaves we are observed on the plants, my dear friends. Whenever the TMV affected plants are infected plants. So TMV infected plants shows the different mosaic colors we are observed on the surface of the leaves, my dear friends. Mosaic means the attractive colors, you know. Mosaic means attractive colors. So these whenever the TMV tobacco mosaic virus infects the plant, the parts of the plant, the leaves of the plant is going to change the color, my dear friends. The greening color and yellowing color of the leaves we are observed are patches observed on the leaves. Even though parts of the branches or stem are also going to turn into yellow, and growth is going to stop. So growth is stopped by this infected virus, that is tobacco mosaic virus. And what is the result? So green pods form pits. Whenever the green pods absorbed on the surface of the leaves, they are going to form pits. So infection in early stage of the leaf is going to twist or malformed. So normal leaf is the leaf blade is a very enlarged leaf blade we are observed in normal leaf. Whenever the infected leaf is going to twist, So here, so this is the normal leaf, my dear friends. This is the normal leaf of the tobacco. Normal leaf. So this is the normal leaf. Normal leaf is looks like here, my dear friends. Normal leaves looks like. Whenever the infection occurred in earlier stage, the leaf is going to a malformed or twisted or zigzag manner or twisted. The leaf is going to twisted inside. Is it right? So these are type of the leaves we are observed on the infected plant, my dear friend. Infected plant. So this is the normal leaf of the tobacco and this is the infected leaf of the tobacco, my dear friends. I will show the next slide, my dear friends, how what is the normal leaf shows looks and where difference from the infected leaves. Okay, and the old leaves of the plant is going to turn into yellow parts is going to brown in color, and partial sterility in pollens also. The pollen also going to in sterile condition, so not in fertile nature. So what we observe, this is the leaf belongs to not tobacco, my dear friends. These leaves belongs to capsicum leaves, you know, capsicum pretensis, mirapa. So capsicum pretensis and capsicum annuus, mirchi, chili. So chilli leaves, just this is the normal leaf. Whenever the TMB affected on Solanaceae member, so chilli belongs to Solanaceae, my dear friends. Remember, chilli is also belongs to Solanaceae family. My dear friends, here this is the normal leaf. Whenever affect TMB, the leaf is going to a multicoloration. Multicoloration means not only green patches, not only yellow patches, orange, brown, or different colors we are observed. This type of leaves we can this type arrangement we can call as mosaic arrangement. Mosaic. Mosaic means attached, a group of bunches of the spotted patches we are observed on the leaves. So here, this is the, my dear friend, this is the actual tobacco plant. So actual tobacco plant, what we observed, Amma? What we observed? So the leaves are folded, you know. The leaves are folded. See here. Some patches, spots we are observed on the leaf. Sir, is there any problem? Is there any problem whenever this TMB affect? Yes, the quality is also decreased and quantity is also decreased. My dear friends, the smokers are very enjoy with this tobacco mosaic virus. Why? Because the TMB affected leaf is giving another odor, another smell to the leaf whenever they are smoking, my dear friends. So smokers are very, very enjoy with this tobacco mosaic virus. Not non-smokers, my dear friends, only smokers are enjoy. So this is very, very important, my dear friends. So we are observed very, very clear patches on the surface of the upper surface of the abaxial adaxial surface of the upper epidermis. We are observed in this normal leaf, how looks like, and the infected leaf, how looks like, my dear friends. Is it right? So these are the patches we are observed in the infected leaf of the crop field. So these are the infected leaves, how we looks. Is it right? So this is no control. Whenever we are the uncontrolled disease or effects on the plants is not able to grow fast, and is also stunted growth we are observed in this plant, even though the quality and quantity is also decreased. So here, these are the controlled crop or plants, how looks. So we are very easily identify the differences between the uncontrolled and controlled plants leaves looks like. So then what is the pathogen? What is the pathogen of this tobacco mosaic disease? We have already discussed about tobacco mosaic virus, you know, TMV. So the TMV virus is also, we can call it as nicotina virus. What is the scientific name? What is the botanical name of tobacco plant, my dear friends? What is the botanical name of tobacco plant? Nicotiana tabacum. Tobacco. Is it right or not? Anybody can respond?
Yes, sir.
Are you listening? Are you hearing?
Yes,
are you listening? Are you hearing? Are you hearing or
listening?
Pakka listening? Very good. Very good, my dear. That's why I'm very happy, because of your interest, that much of interest, increasing my zeal to give additional information related to this our class. So this virus is a rod shaped virus, you know. The size of the virus is 300 nanometer long, the diameter 15 to 18 nanometer length. This virus is transmission. The virus of the transmission, sap is transmissible by wounds. Our scientists first identified through leaf sap, you know. The leaf extraction is identified. Our visoring, Martinez visoring, he stated that leaf sap or the leaf extract is able to infect the healthy plant, that is Contagium vivum fluidum. He stated that then not only sap transmission, even though the seed transmission in tobacco, tomato, but not in tobacco. Tobacco is only leaves, sap transmissible. No insect vector is known. The specific vector is still now not identified, my dear friends. The research is waiting for you, my dear friends. The research is waiting for you. Not only even a single mode of transmission, that is sap transmission, is enough. No, the insects is also caused by the this virus, my dear friends, from infected plant to healthy plant. So what are the insects are caused or responsible for the transmission of this virus? So in front of us, this challenge is ready, my dear friends. Which type of vector is responsible for the transmission of this tobacco mosaic virus in the among the crop field, my dear friends? And mechanical transmission, though this is very, very important. Mechanical transmission, very, very important among the crop field, my dear friends. Why? Because the whenever the farmers are move among the crop, among the plants, they are infect knowingly or unknowingly infect the healthy plant from infected plant. And mechanical transmission by using number of tools, you know, agricultural tools. Okay, the tools also responsible for the transmission of this virus. So in electron microscope, this 100 nanometer length of this virus, this is rod shaped virus looks like here, my dear friend. This is TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. Then disease management, removal of crop residues, resides and infected plants. So what we can say, what we can do that? First of all, we should remove the infected plants from the crop. And removal of solanaceous weeds, my dear friends. Why we can say that? Because of so all solanaceous members are for the transmission of the this virus are affected. In fact, this virus infect all solanaceous members, you know. TMV virus infect not only tobacco, all solanaceous members like potato, tomato, datura, capsicum. Okay, so very, very important point, my dear friends. Crop rotation each every 2 years. Crop rotation is important. Crop rotation. Panta marpidi vidhanam antam telugu. So crop rotation. Crop rotation means from this year we have to cultivate on the land in this year tobacco. But next year we should change the crop, whether the cultivate not only solanaceous members, other solanaceous members like grasslands like jowar, bajra, even though maize, wheat. So these are the other type of crops we should cultivate on the same land. We is right. The crop rotation is helpful for the control of the disease, my friend. And wash hands with trisodium phosphate. Whenever we are using our hands by the picking of the crop. What we can say, the fruits and picking up the weeds in the among the crop field, after completion of the work, we should wash our hands with trisodium phosphate and wash agri equipments in trisodium phosphate. And why, dear friends? No smoking. So no smoking. Smoking is also one of the cause, my dear friends. So this is also transmission, one of the mode of transmission. And this is very, very, very important. And why is this? Any type of the crops, disease resistance varieties are most important, my dear friends. Okay, this is today's topic, that is rice tungro virus and tobacco mosaic virus, my dear friends. Is there any doubt? Please ask me, I will clarify.
No, sir.
No. Okay. Madam.
सर मैम
गर्ल्स टेल मी
मैम सार प्रीवियस वी पीपीटी पेटमन चेप्पंडी मैम
नेने पेड़ता ना कुछ कॉलेज लो बिजी उन्नानु।